Hey guys, hope you're having a great week, and or for those of you who are in school, which you're getting all your work done, and you're getting ready for summer. It won't be long, we'll be going on vacation. I know me and my family go on vacation in a week from now, so we're really looking forward to that, and being able to get to the beach and spend some time outside. So I hope you guys are getting outside. Hope you're having fun playing outside, and that mom and dad can spend some time with you, and that you guys are enjoying the time that you have at home. We've got a service for you this morning, and we're going to still be talking about Abraham and his big test. You know, life is like a test. For all of us, we have things that happen in our lives that God asks us to do, or things that we go through. But one thing that we always know that God is with us, right? Jesus, once we ask him to come into our heart and live in us and be our Savior, that we never have to worry about anything we face in this life, because he says, I'm always going to be with you. And that's what Abraham's big test is all about. Just seeing God, seeing if Abraham will follow him no matter what. So you guys have a great Sunday today. And you watch the Vine Kids service. Post some videos for us of you dancing with the songs, or listening to the Bible story, and we'll put them up on the Vine Kids page. But hopefully we will see you guys soon. Mom and Dad, there are some Bible app plans that we've put up for you guys, if you would like to join in on a Bible app, Bible plan. And be sure to check out the Bible app for kids, Mom and Dad, if you hadn't already. There's some great things on there for the kids. Everything that we do that you see on here on a Sunday is the Bible story itself is from the Bible app. So you can go on the Bible app and watch interactive stories from the Bible. There are lots of them on there. So you can download the Bible app for kids, and there are a lot of things that will occupy the kids and let them learn more about God and more about Jesus and how much he loves us and how much he cares about us. So you check those things out, and you guys have a great week, and hopefully I will see you right back here next Sunday. And we only have a couple more weeks, and then we'll be back at church at the YMCA in downtown Spartanburg, and looking forward so much to see you guys. And I'll give you more information about that right before we do meet. But you guys have a great week, and I will see you right here next Sunday. Bye.
Hi, families. Are you ready to go on a Bible adventure? Me too. But before we see Emily and Shine, it's time for Prop Talk. Friends, what do I have today? That's right. It's a clock. What's a clock for? That's right. It tells us what time it is. It also reminds us to wait patiently with a good attitude. Can you show me a smile for a good attitude? Those are great smiles! Friends, do you guys want to play a game to help us wait patiently? Yay! Okay, it's called the Froggy Jumping Game. So I need you guys to crouch like your little froggies. Can you crouch down really low? Okay, so here's what we're gonna do. My clock is at the number 3, and when my clock gets all the way to the top, we're gonna jump up like we're frogs. Can you jump like a frog? Great job, friends. Crouch down. Okay, are you frozen? Are you still like a stone? Good job. Okay, we're waiting. We're waiting with a good attitude. Can you show me your smiles? Great job. Okay, we're waiting. We're waiting, almost there, but we're still waiting. Jump up, froggies! Great job, friends! Do you guys want to try again? Okay, here we go. Let's crouch down. Okay, friends, are you like a frog? Are you being so still? Okay, we're waiting. We might have to wait a little longer. Okay. We're waiting with a good attitude. Yay, jump froggies! Great job, friends. You waited with such a good attitude. Did you know when you wait with a good attitude, you're showing faith? Yes, waiting with a good attitude shows faith because we trust that God will give us what we need at the right time. Are you guys ready to go on our Bible adventure? Shake your hands high in the sky. Woohoo!
On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. So much in the Bible for me to know on my Bible adventure. I want to know that God is real. I want to know how I could be his friend. I want to know who Jesus is. I want to find out what the Bible's all about. Hey! Do-do-do-do. Do-do-do-do. Do-do-do. La-la-la-la. La-la-la-la. La-la-la. On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. So many ways that I will grow on my Bible adventure. I'm gonna learn my memory verse. I'm gonna pray and talk to God. I'm gonna sing new songs to God and keep singing the songs all week long. Oh, do 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 do, do 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 do, do do do, la 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 la, la 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 la, la la la. On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. Church is a fun place we can go on a Bible adventure.
Wiggle my waggle! Hi friends, I'm Emily. Shine the Star sent me the question, how do you show faith? I'm going on a Bible adventure to find out! Shake your hands high in the sky if you'll go with me. Woohoo! Let's put on our adventure bags.
Woohoo! Whee! Hiya, friends.
Hi, Shine. We're getting ready for our Bible adventure.
Did you pack your picture passes?
Not yet. What's in my trunk?
Oh, I know. The first one is something that has numbers on it and tells the time.
Friends, which picture pass is it? The clock! Open your adventure bags.
Okay, this one's inside your head. You think and remember with it.
You're right, as a green light! The brain! Put it in your adventure bags!
Now for the last one. When you add water and sunshine, it'll grow.
What could it be? A seed! A seed grows! We've got them all! Count them with me, friends! 1, 2, 3! Let's zip our adventure bags together! Now it's time to fly! Whoa! Whoa! Shine, I read the question, how do you show faith? But I don't know what faith is.
Faith is trusting and believing.
Trusting and believing? Maybe our picture passes will help. We have a clock, a brain, and a seed. Oh, Shine, I still don't get it.
Then let's watch a story from the Bible that's all about faith.
The Bible is God's book for you. You can trust. It's right and true.
Abraham's big test. That's from the book of Genesis.
I've heard of Abraham before. He was a real person who lived a really long time ago. Friends, maybe Abraham can show us what faith means.
God promised Abraham a son, and from that son, many descendants, who would bless the whole world. But Abraham and his wife Sarah were too old to have children. 20 years went by. Still, Abraham trusted God's promise. When he was 100 and Sarah was 90, God reminded them of his promise. Sarah was going to have a baby. When their son was born, Sarah was so joyful that she laughed. God has brought me laughter, she said. So they named their son Isaac, which means he laughs. When Isaac was a boy, God tested Abraham by telling him to take Isaac to Mount Moriah and kill him as a sacrifice to God. Abraham was confused, but still he trusted God. Isaac carried the wood, and Abraham held the knife and torch. Together they climbed the mountain. "Where is the lamb for the sacrifice?" asked Isaac.
"God will provide it," Abraham replied.
Abraham arranged the wood on an altar, tied up Isaac, and laid him on the wood. As he raised the knife to kill Isaac, an angel called his name.
"Abraham, don't hurt the boy," the angel cried. "God knows you trust his promise. Look, there in the bushes, a ram is caught by its horns. Sacrifice that instead."
So Abraham sacrificed the ram instead of his son. He called the place God Will Provide, because God provided the sacrifice. Just as God had said, his promise came true.
Did you see how Abraham trusted and believed?
Yeah, God told Abraham that he was going to give him a son. Abraham believed God, and God kept his promise.
Abraham trusted and believed God, so he obeyed God to show faith.
Obey? Obey! How do you show faith?
I show faith every day when I trust and obey. Whee! That's the answer to the question.
I wonder if Blinky and Cloudette know about faith.
I don't know. I'll go find out.
And I'll find out about these picture passes on our Bible adventure. Come on!
Oh, that Abraham, he sure showed some faith. Oh, hi, Emily.
Hi, Guy.
Look at this.
What is it? What is it?
I just learned in my favorite book, the Bible, about a man who showed a lot of faith.
So did we.
What? You did?
Yeah.
Friends, who do you learn about with Emily?
It was Abraham. But we still don't know what it really means to show faith.
Faith. Let me see. Ooh. Faith means trusting and believing.
That's what Shine said. But how did Abraham trust and believe?
Remember when God made a promise to Abraham?
Yeah, God told Abraham that he would give him a son, even though Abraham and his wife Sarah were too old.
But he had faith. He trusted and believed God the whole time. And God gave him a son when he was 100 years old.
That reminds me of one of our picture passes. Count them with me, friends. 1, 2, 3. Great. Now, which one has numbers on it and tells the time? It is the clock!
A clock reminds you to show faith in God by waiting, even if it takes a long time.
I think I need a Bible verse to help me remember to trust God while I wait.
Oh, I have one! Friends, wiggle your ears if you're ready to learn a verse with me.
I'm wiggling my ears. Are you wiggling yours?
Okay, watch first.
Okay.
Psalm 31:14. I trust in you, Lord. I say, you are my God, you are my God, you are my God! Okay, repeat after me.
Okay.
Psalm 31:14.
Psalm 31:14.
I trust.
I trust
in you, Lord.
In you, Lord.
I say.
You are my God, you are my God, you are my God!
You are my God, you are my God, you are my God!
Okay, great job, friends. Now, let's do the whole verse together.
Yeah.
Psalm 31:14. I trust
in you, Lord.
I say,
You are my God!
Jumping jambalaya! When I have to wait, I'll trust God. He is my God.
Trusting God is a way to obey.
That reminds me of the question. How do you show faith?
I show faith every day when I trust and obey.
I'll remember that on our Bible adventure. Bye, guy.
See ya.
Come on.
Ooh. I can't share. It's just a box anyway.
But I heard Mr. Stone say you had to.
Blinky, what's in that box?
Oh, all right already.
Oh la la, bubbles. Let's play bubbles.
No bubbles.
Why are you being so selfish?
I just super dee duper love bubbles. If I share, you guys will use it all up, and I'll have to wait forever.
Wait? For what?
Well, to get more bubbles, of course.
But Mr. Stone told you to share.
Yeah, and he said he'd give me more after they're all gone.
So what's the big deal?
What if Mr. Stone forgets? Then I'll never get any bubbles.
Blinky, you need to have some faith in Mr. Stone. Trust, believe, obey.
Trust, believe, obey?
God is so good. He gave you Mr. Stone to take care of you.
Yeah, God did give me Mr. Stone to take care of me when Mommy's busy. I know he loves me. I really do trust him. But I'll be so sad if I don't get more bubbles.
Abraham felt like that, too. He knew God loved him. He trusted God. But do you think Abraham wanted to give his only son back to God?
No way. That is too sad. Abraham shouldn't do that.
Abraham did do it because he had faith. He believed, trusted, and obeyed God.
Shine, Abraham lived a long time ago. That's why he could be so brave and obey. I'm just a little bug. I can't do it.
You can because God put a tiny faith seed in your heart when you ask Jesus to be your leader. It'll grow every time you remember God is real and loves you.
I think I feel that faith seed growing right now. I can trust and believe God.
Whee! Claudette!
Whee-whee!
I'm gonna share all my bubbles with you guys. I'll show faith in God by trusting Mr. Stone and obeying.
Yay!
Yay!
Well, now we know what the clock's for. We show faith by trusting and believing in God, even when we have to wait. But what about the other two? Say them with me, friends. A brain and a seed. Do you hear that? It sounds like it's coming from Mr. Music's singing studio. Let's go. Mr. Music! Oh boy, I'm sure glad that you're here. We've got to ask you a question.
Ask away.
How do you show faith?
I show faith every day when I trust and obey.
Yeah, that's the answer. And Guy the Bible Guy taught us this verse to help. Psalm 31:14. I trust in you, Lord. I say, You are my God, you are my God, you are my God!
Wow! That verse reminds me of a man in the Bible named Abraham.
Yakety yo-yos! We know about him.
Do you remember when God asked Abraham to give his son Isaac back?
I do remember that part. It was sad and kind of scary.
Yes, but Abraham had faith in God, so he obeyed God.
Mr. Music, why did Abraham have faith to obey God?
Because Abraham remembered that God kept his promise to give him a son.
Remember! That reminds me of one of our picture passes. Whew! Count with me, friends. 1, 2, 3! Now, which picture pass is it?
It's something inside your head. You think and remember with it.
The brain! Abraham used his brain to remember the promise God kept.
When Abraham was scared or worried, he remembered what God did before and believed that God would take care of him again.
Can we do that too?
Sure you can. In fact, I know a song that'll help. Friends, clap your hands together if you'd like to sing a song with me.
I'm clapping my hands. Are you clapping yours?
Do you want to sing it from the beginning?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Repeat after me.
Okay.
I want faith like Abraham.
I want faith like Abraham.
When I can't, I know God can.
When I can't, I know God can.
Why should I be scared or worried?
Why should I be scared or worried?
I know that my God is with me.
I know that my God is with me.
That was great. Here we go.
I can trust my God. I can trust him and obey. I can trust Jesus. I can trust him and obey.
F-f-f-faith. That was great. Here we go.
When a problem comes my way,
when a problem comes my way,
I can look to God and pray.
I can look to God and pray.
And why should I be scared or worried?
Why should I be scared or worried?
I know that my God is with me.
I know that my God is with me.
Yeah.
I can trust my God, I can trust him and obey. I can trust Jesus, I can trust him and obey. I can trust my God, I can trust him and obey. I can trust Jesus, I can trust him and obey.
B-b-b-faith.
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 Faith, 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 faith.
That was great! Now, stand up on your feet to worship God with singing, music, and dancing.
Count on Jesus. I can always count.
I'm gonna run, run, run to his love, love, love. I'm gonna sing, sing, sing to God's Son. I'm gonna shout, shout, shout the name of Jesus. He is the one I trust. When I'm alone, when I'm afraid, I know that He is with me every day. He's by my side, He hears me when I pray. Jesus, I trust in Him. I'm gonna run, run, run to His love, love, love. I'm gonna sing, sing, sing to God's Son. I'm gonna shout, shout, shout the name of Jesus. He is the one I trust.
Bible Guy taught us a verse about faith. Say it with me, friends. Psalm 31:14. I trust in you, Lord. I say, you are my God, you are my God, you are my God.
So faith means you'll trust God and believe He's always your God.
Yeah, and the verse helps us remember the answer to the question. Ask us the question, Shine, ask us the question.
How do you show faith?
I show faith every day when I trust and obey.
Whee! And the picture passes?
Count with me, friends. One, two, three. The clock helps us remember to trust and obey God, even when we have to wait a really long time. And the brain helps us remember what God did before, so we can trust and believe God now. But, Shine, what about the seed?
When you choose Jesus as your leader, you get a teeny tiny seed of faith in your heart.
Well, if it's so tiny, how will it help me trust and believe God more?
Like a seed, faith grows. Every time you trust, believe, and obey God, it's like giving water and sunshine to your faith seed.
Well, what'll a tiny faith seed grow up to be?
It'll grow into kind, loving actions. When your faith grows big and strong, your actions will help other people trust, believe, and obey God too. God promises to help you grow your faith. Pray to God, and He'll keep that promise.
Let's do that right now. Okay, bow your head and close your eyes. We're gonna talk to God together. Dear God, help us to show faith. Give us patience. And help us remember the promises that you've kept and grow our faith seed. In Jesus' name, amen. Great giggling geckos! It's time to go! We'll see you next time!
For another Bible adventure!
Bye-bye, friends!
Friends, I had so much fun on our Bible adventure! But we're not done just yet! What time is it? Picture pass time! Can you guys put on your adventure bags with me? 1, 2, 3, whoosh! Alrighty, friends, I have my picture passes in here. Do you guys remember what they are? You guys are so smart! Okay, let's see which one I find first. Are you guys ready? Okay, let's see which one. What's this one? That's right! It's the brain! Can you guys point at the brain? Say, there's my brain. Great job, friends. What does our brain help us do? It helps us remember. Great job. So friends, when you remember the good things God's done, does it make your faith bigger or smaller? Bigger! You guys are so smart. All right, friends, let's see which one I find next. Okay, I wonder which one it'll be. Let's see if you're right. What's this one? That's right, it's the clock. Can you guys say, I can wait? Great job, you guys sound amazing today. So friends, is faith waiting for God with a good attitude or a bad attitude? With a good attitude. Can you guys show me those big smiles? Those are great smiles. All right, friends, I have one more picture pass. Do you guys know what it is? Okay, let's see if you're right. What is this? That's right, it's my faith seed. So friends, what good things can you do to help your faith seed grow bigger and bigger? Those are some great answers. We can trust and obey God. Great job, friends. All of my picture passes help me remember that I show faith every day when I trust and obey. Friends, I had so much fun on our Bible adventure. Did you have fun too? Yay! Okay, well, there's some questions on the next slide that you can talk about with your family. You can tell them all about what you learned from Emily and Shine. All right, friends, I hope you guys have an awesome week. Bye!